Hello, everyone. How are you doing? Well, today we're going to talk about AI agents across the user experience of your business. And we'll start off with a question. What is the only constant that we can be sure of? For those of you that have attended our sessions before, you might know the answer, but it's always good to remind ourselves. What's the one thing that we can actually be sure is going to happen? I'm sure you know it by now, and that is change. Change is the one thing we can guarantee is going to happen, and it's actually happening faster and faster, especially when it comes to the field of AI. Now, we were all blown away by how fast social media took over the world, and you know, it started off with Facebook, but then TikTok was the really amazing company that sort of grew so fast, reaching 100 million users in 9 months. But then ChatGPT from OpenAI came out, and within the first 2 months, it was able to have 100 million users. So the pace of change is happening much faster, especially in this field of AI. And we moved over the past 2 years from, you know, AI that is really great in languages and text, to being great in images, to being great in music, to being great in video production, more recently, great in research, sciences, and being amazing in reasoning. And today what's happening is that we're getting all of these models under one umbrella, which is the AI agents that we'll talk about in a bit. So what does this mean for your business? Imagine that you have the access to a group of talented individuals, talented MBA graduates that have graduated from some of the top universities in the world. Imagine that they're available to you to make use of in your business. Imagine that these MBA graduates are also amazing and have PhDs in science, and have PhDs in philosophy and ethics and history. Imagine that you have access to all that talent. What would you do with it in your business? I want you to think about having this 100 plus team members of sales and customer service members in your team available to support you. What would you do with them? This isn't just an imagination, this is actually available today. 2025 is the year of AI agents, and the AI agents bring together that set of talent and make it available to you. Now let's look at a typical business. You'd usually have three main touch points. There's the physical touch point, which could be a branch of a bank. It could be a retail store that you have. It could be a hotel, lobby, various touch points for the physical presence. You also have the website, social media, the online presence, and you have the telephone system where people can call in. Now imagine you introduce intelligence across these different touch points. In the physical presence, you have robots, embodied robots that have AI inside them. That can do different things like guide users across the different physical location. There are many restaurants now that use these embodied AI to provide, to take orders, to bring food. Japan is really quite advanced in that, that kind of service. And you're going to see more and more of this, where these touch points have these intelligent, whether humanoid robots or general purpose robots, that guide the users across the physical presence. Then when you look at the online presence, you've got chatbots, voice bots that also engage and interact with users based on where they are, whether they're browsing on social media and they want to talk to an AI bot or chat with it on WhatsApp, whatever is the mechanism that they would be comfortable in doing so. And then you have the telephone system. in the old days, that was the predominant and only way for users to get in touch with companies. But companies found this very expensive operating, you know, call centers. So they started to move people towards these IVR systems because they were cheaper systems that, you know, you press one for this service or two for that service. And these IVR systems are not that user friendly. People don't like dealing with them. So there was a big problem in expanding the call center operations, the places where people can call the telephone line to get answers. And that's why you see a lot of companies these days don't use these call centers, because it was prohibitive. But now with AI agents, we can bring back this really important channel where people would like to interact with companies through a telephone line. You can have these AI agents answering the calls, intelligently answer the questions of the customer, or help in clarifying product overviews, help in your sales process. So infusing AI agents across these different touch points can really take your services to the next level and improve the customer experience overall. So let's take an example of a buying process and look at it at that level. So a typical buying process involves, you know, a discovery phase, people looking for the product, then finding the product, hopefully buying it in an efficient way if they like it, and they get all their the questions answered, getting that product delivered to them quite efficiently, and then once they get that product, to experience a great experience in using it. So now, I mean, let's take each stage. If you look at the initial stage, the discovery phase, people are going to be searching for the product or browsing on social media and getting an advertisement for it, or seeing an influencer talk about it. And then they would want to engage, maybe to ask some extra questions. Maybe they want to call. And this is where you start to, you know, ideally provide the users with whatever mechanism they would like to interact with, whether it's a text bot or voice bot, depending on the situation and depending on their preference. They could interact with any of these. And ideally, you want these both interaction points to be tied to an agentic workflow that provides a similar experience, whatever touch point that they interact with. And actually, they could continue with that journey. So if someone is texting, inquiring about something, and then they call the voice agent will pick up from where the texting happened. This is really important, for example, in airline bookings. If you're booking a ticket, you're asking a few questions on text, then you call, you want the voice agent to continue from where you left at the from the texting part. You don't want them to, you don't want the users to repeat everything that they did before. So these are important to tie the different channels into an agentic workflow. We already have a lot of these templates ready to go when it comes to sales services that can be customized for different customers' journeys. And then you would provide the seamless experience for your users. So let's look at the purchasing cycle again in the case of a product. So because the product, when you see it in a product, from a product angle, it's quite easy to visualize. So let's take an example of a product. You search for it on Google or on Amazon, you find it. So this product is a mug or a cup. With Amazon, they've perfected the buying process with this one-click buying process that allows people to quickly buy without having to put their credit card information again. And then with Prime, they could get maybe same day or next day delivery for free, which also improves the delivery experience. And finally, they get that mug and they use it. And, you know, it is as advertised, because Amazon does a job of validating that their products are really the right products that have been advertised. So this is quite straightforward when it comes to physical products that can be taken and mapped across such a journey. What we need to do if we have solution selling, solutions that we're selling, or services, that we need to think of them as if they were products. What can we take from our offerings and productize that could then be offered to our users? That's a very important process. So if you have, for example, a complicated solution, and you know people can't buy it immediately, can you break it up into smaller chunks where people can experience and buy? You might offer them a membership service that they could buy, where they get a taste, you know, or a feel, or some aspect of that solution. You might do like what SaaS companies do, software as a service companies, where you know they offer you the software, you subscribe to it, and you use it. If you like it, you use the free version. If you like it, you subscribe to the premium version, and you continue using the product as is. So again, these examples take a complicated software or solutions product or offering and productize it into something that can be quickly sold, you know, and tried out by the users. And this is where AI agents become really useful, because they could be there through this whole journey, answering questions and helping conclude the sale. Customers, when they're browsing for a product, they need some convincing, they have sometimes some reservations or questions, and they want reinforcement, reassurance about the decisions that they're making. And this is where AI agents could be really good in comforting them by answering the questions, understanding their needs, and explaining to them the benefits of the product that they're offering. So you could do this, like we said, through interactive chatbots that can be embedded at different parts of that cycle. They could pop up at the social media level, through when, you know, if you have an ad that you're providing, or available on different parts of your website, on the main home page, or on the products page, where they are experts in the specific products or solutions that you're offering on your website. Now, the other form is, of course, what we were discussing before, this voice-based agents, where same thing, they're well aware of your products or services. Of course, they could also act as customer service, and support. And if you'd want to try some of these live, you could go to ai.potential.com/Rachel. You can see here. And Rachel is our AI agent that could walk you through the process of setting up a demo AI bot for your business. And you could see this whole experience firsthand. The experience we're talking about, where, you know, you can, we'll go back to it over here, where you have the AI agent walk you through the whole process of experiencing the product, answering your questions, guiding you through it. If you're happy with it, sending you the invoice or the link to pay the bill, and be able to then use the actual product at an extended version. So in the beginning, you would use it at, you know, in a light version. Then if you purchase it, you get the full package and you'll be happy with the experience because you've already tried the product. But the important thing is the AI agent from the discovery stage all through that process is involved in guiding you through that journey. So if you like to give it a try, go to ai.potential.com/Rachel and give it a try. And this is, again, not something that's way out in the future. It's actually happening today. I'm going to show you a few examples of companies using this. So here's a dating coach, AI dating coach company that provides different kinds of coaching services through text and voice to its customers. People can, you know, ask questions 24/7. And they get a certain amount of questions for free. After that, they need to subscribe to a premium version. They could also personalize their own bots for their specific use cases to give them more personalized information. So all of these are like optional items that can be used through this AI-powered platform. Then you have this other example where a company that has skincare products interacts with the users, that helps them upload photos of them and answers questions, and then be able to interact with them and give them advice about what would be the best products to use for their kind of skin and the kind of issues that they're facing. Here's another example of a company in the UK using the bots across their website for general information about the services and products, but also using the bot as a career guide for their customers that do the psychometric assessments, helping them take their psychometric assessment results and guiding them in terms of what would be the best career paths for them using the service. So again, taking that service to the next level. And here's a personalized tutor for all ages, available also in voice form and text form to help people learn anything. Another example of the AI touch points you can see on the website. So from the main interactions, as people come to the website, they can start talking to the bot that guides them through using the service, experiencing it, but also subscribing to the full service. And here's another example of a company that does toolkits for their target audiences. Here's a sales AI sales toolkit that covers the different sales process. People can try some of these kits, and then they have to subscribe to basically get access to various AI tools across the different sales process. So these are different examples, and according to BCG, companies that do play around, experiment with AI in their different life cycle produce amazing results. And this is something that I'd encourage you to do. Like we talked at the beginning, AI is moving really fast. The best way to stay, you know, engaged and to make use of it is to experiment. Use it in your customer journey. Reimagine your customer journey and see if you can find ways in which you can optimize it, given how easy it is now to engage AI tools across that journey. So I, you know, encourage you to experiment, you know, try some of the products. If you go to ai.potential.com/Rachel, she could also guide you. And I hope to hear about the great results and returns that you're having, and look forward to seeing you next week. All the best.